You all have ductwork either in your attic or your crawl space or something like that, possibly in an unfinished basement. Well, if they're not properly sealed, they are stealing money from you. So you need to make sure you watch this video. Stay tuned. Here's a great example of what we come across a lot in basements, attics, and crawl spaces. This is a typical HVAC air duct line. As you can see, the trunk has been pretty well insulated, and the run is actually a flex line with a metal collar, and they insulated up to the trunk line. The problem is the metal collar has tabs that allows air to escape where it meets the trunk line. So when they installed it, they did not do any type of air sealing. So that collar where the main trunk and the run meets is leaking a ton of air. And in this picture, it shows you that the insulation is exposed because the adhesive, the tape that they used, has become to come away. And the reason why is because it's in a hot attic, and of course, wear and tear from the heat makes it pull away from the insulation. Okay, I want to take just a minute and show you this part right here. You want to make sure you get the insulation cut out away from this tab so that you can take the mastic and put on that tab securely. Before we move on, I thought it'd be a good idea to tell you why you even want to go through the trouble and the hassle and the possible expense of insulating and air sealing your duct system. According to energystar.gov, a duct system that is well designed and properly sealed can make your home more comfortable, energy efficient, and safer. They basically listed five different areas that you're going to see benefits from when you air seal your ducts. Number one is comfort. Sealing and insulating the ducts will help in common comfort problems, such as rooms that are too hot in the summer and too cold in the winter, for example. Indoor air quality. Fumes from household and garden chemicals, insulation particles, dust, different things like that get in the duct system. Insulation fibers is huge in the basement and the crawl space where you got these exposed ducts. And if you got a dirty, nasty crawl space, you're sucking in the mold and mildew and whatever is down there. These can aggravate asthma and allergy problems. So sealing those ducts can help improve indoor air quality and reduce the risk of pollutants that enter the ducts and then circulate throughout your home. Number three is safety. If you've got a gas water heater or a gas furnace, a leaky duct can produce what's called a backdraft, where these gases are drawn back into the living space rather than expelled to the outdoors like they're supposed to be. So sealing these leaks can minimize that risk as well. Saving money. That's as you notice, that's the fourth reason. Comfort is the first, indoor air quality is the second, safety is the third, saving money is the fourth. Most of our customers don't seal ducts just to save money. They have a problem, an indoor air quality problem, a comfort problem that they want to correct. But in doing that, you're going to save money. The Department of Energy says that you lose 20 to 30%. Did you hear that? 20 to 30% of the air that you make in that heating and cooling process inside the HVAC system is lost inside a leaky duct. So think about it this way. Let's be conservative and say 25%. Let's split the difference. For every dollar you spend on heating and cooling your home, which is 50% in most cases of your energy bill, is to heat and cool your home. Every dollar you spend, 25 cents of that dollar is lost in a leaky duct system. So this could save you a lot of money over time. And then the fifth reason would be to protect the environment. Obviously, the less energy we use, the less we have a problem with the environment and the less fossil fuels we use or whatever. And those are the five reasons why that the energystar.gov recommends and shows the benefits of duct sealing. Okay, hopefully that information I shared with you was useful. Let's get back to the project at hand. This is the foil tape with the mastic on it that we like to use. This is a great tape. It's pretty thick. It's a little expensive. It's probably $25-$30 a roll or more. So I've seen it as high as $70. So you can see how I applied that first piece to the collar and also to the main trunk line. And the foil tape, if you notice, has a white backing on it. So you'll have to take that white part off in order to expose the mastic. Now what you're going to do, there's the mastic exposed, and you would take that and put it on just like I've done in those two areas in sections like that. It's just a little easier to work with if you cut it in small sections, and then you can adjust it as you go around. Now you can see on this part, I've already taken care of all the way around in small sections. Just cut little small slivers of the mastic tape. You can also use regular mastic adhesive, or what they call duct butter. But with these collars where they have large gaps, the mastic tape seems to work a little better in those situations. Then what you can do is you can roll out a longer piece of mastic and then seal where those smaller pieces come together with the duct. Okay, now here we have an air duct where the two main trunk lines come together. As you can see, they used sheet metal screws to tie these two together, and then used a duct tape to kind of join the joints here. It's a very thin duct tape. So what I'm going to do is I cut away the insulation, as you can see, just to make sure we do it right. We're going to go ahead and insulate or air seal this joint, and then every joint we find, you can figure, depending on the run, is probably every 6 feet. So you can see there's where we finished up the run, and the connector that was there, used mastic tape on it, and now we're going to do the seam just down the run from it a little bit. I think you're better off using one whole piece if you can. As you can see, I got one long piece to wrap all the way around the duct. So now we're going to take the backing off and connect it to the trunk. Now once you get it to stick on there, it's a good idea to take your hand and kind of make sure you press it down. Now I don't know if you noticed, but I did not take it off. I didn't take the duct tape off that was on there, because duct tape is a hard tape to get on if it's been on there a while. So you go ahead and rub it and seal it real good, this mastic will stay on there real well. So that's a way you can do the seam. Get up a little further. So now you see that the seam's been done, and also that run has been done. Okay, so this is with the insulation put back together. Please keep in mind that I cut the insulation pretty wide so that you all could see what exactly I was doing, but the neater you keep the insulation cut, the sharper your knife, the easier this is to put back together. Also, the thicker the tape. This is a little bit thin two-sided foil tape, or two-piece foil tape. As you can see, the brown down there, that's the backing. Sticks a little better. You can also go, there's different kind of foil tapes out there. This is not a mastic tape, this is actually a foil tape that we use on the insulation itself. So here's the joint. We brought it all back together. You can see all that I had to cut out, just to give you an idea so I could show you for the camera. But you normally don't have to cut that much of the insulation. So hope this helps you out. And if you like this video, please like this video down below. And my name's Michael Church, in an attic, sweating to death, so we can make your house more energy efficient. Have a great day.
How are you gonna get back?
No, I didn't turn it on. Did you turn it on? I don't know if I can get him out of this wood without hurting him, but I'm gonna try. Hi, found a snake. There he is. Yeah, he's a rat snake. Look at him. Come on out of there, big boy. Easy does it. Easy.
Come look at him. We see. We found him. We found the entire snake.
Oh, look at him. Look at him. He's ready to strike.
Maybe I should back up a little bit.
All right. All right.
Hey, Seth, get all back, right.
He's a little one.